So guys, I am currently in Buenos Aires in Argentina, and this is like one of my favorite cities to stay in on a long-term basis as a digital nomad. As you can see, the weather here is great. The climate in particular, like, it's just perfect temperature. I spent the last 7 months or so in Southeast Asia and it was just getting too hot and too humid. But here in Buenos Aires, it's just perfect weather, perfect temperature. And it stays like this for around 9 months of the year. It only gets like really cold in winter, and even then it's not too cold. And it doesn't rain too much here either, it's just perfect weather. And it's full of parks, full of really, really nice looking, well-kept parks everywhere. As you can see, I'm in one of them right now. Check this out, this is another park just right next to the one that I was in previously. And I don't think the camera really does it justice, it's like even nicer than it looks. And just across the road there we've got the museum. And it's a pretty big one and it's also free. So you don't have to pay anything to get in, which is nice. And if we walk further along, up ahead, up in an area called Palermo, they've got a free zoo. So that's like another thing that I really like about Buenos Aires. You don't have to spend too much money here to enjoy yourself. And as you can see, I'm still surrounded by parks, just lots of parks everywhere. Like here in this area that I'm in now called Recoleta. Really known for its parks, and further up ahead is another really nice affluent area called Palermo, and that's another area full of really nice parks, bars, restaurants, just all sorts. Across the road there, right across the road, you can see another park, it's a pretty big one, and they've built a lot of new exercise equipment there just over the last 12 months. They've even built a little basketball court there as well. So yeah, like, this is Tuesday afternoon around 2 o'clock now, and at night time, well, in the evenings, you'll see a lot of people doing exercise in the parks. They've even got like exercise classes that you can join where they do all sorts of different types of aerobic exercise and fitness and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, it's really nice. People like to keep fit, they go jogging. As you can see just across the road there, people jogging and stuff. And this little park here to my left now, this is like my little thinking hill. As you can see, it's like a little hill there, and you often go to the top just to think and contemplate and scheme and plan my next moves, my next adventures. Yeah, this is it here. On the weekends, people like to go like sunbathing up here as well. They don't have any beaches here, but they do have like really, really nice parks that people go to, so it's like the next best thing. As you can see also, they've got lots of statues and monuments and stuff here as well. Yeah, like I said, it's Tuesday afternoon, so it's quite quiet here. Like most people are working. The other thing I like about Buenos Aires in particular is it's not too touristy. You know, some of the other places that I've been to in Southeast Asia, for example, it's like a little bit too touristy, like places like Bali, for example, in Indonesia. I feel like it's just overrun by tourism now. Tourists and expats and digital nomads and stuff. And yeah, it's just kind of ruined it for me a little bit. But this place, it's not too touristy, so it's like still perfect, still really nice. a couple of weeks ago, like 2 to 3 weeks ago, Buenos Aires was hit with like a massive swarm of mosquitoes, and it was really annoying. They were just attacking everyone. Like, I would just see people walking by just covered in mosquito bites, like covered with lots of red mosquito bites. It was pretty funny. But yeah, it's not too bad now. Most of them seem to have either gone or died, but yeah, it's not too bad now. But it was really bad 2 to 3 weeks ago when they first arrived. You couldn't really go to a park like this without being hounded by mosquitoes. Yeah, so this is an exercise area that they just built within the last 12 months. So here you can do calisthenic exercises, which is what I do pretty much every week. And here also. This whole area was just built within the last 12 months, because when I was here this time last year, all of this area was empty. There was nothing here. So people used to just like come out here and rollerblade and bike ride and stuff like that in this little area here. But over the last 12 months, they've built all this training exercise equipment and stuff. They've even built some little basketball courts over there, which is nice because I like to play basketball. And they did something similar over on the other park down there as well. They've built another little basketball court and some other calisthenic exercise equipment there as well. So yeah, I like to go there too. Yeah, all this was empty. Another reason why I think Buenos Aires is a good place to stay in long term as a digital nomad is the cost of living. I think if you earn your money in like a high value currency such as the British pound or the US dollar or the euro, you're going to find that it's quite cheap compared to Western places like the US or Western Europe. But if you come here and you start working for an Argentinian company and you earn your salary in Argentinian pesos, you won't find it cheap. You'll find it quite expensive. But yeah, the currency here is quite a lot inflated at the moment. So, and it's been like that for a while. It's just been more and more. The inflation's here is just, it's crazy. But like I said, if you earn your income in a high value currency, if you can get like some sort of online business or online remote work, you'll find that it's quite cost effective. It doesn't cost you that much to live. Look, just more parks, more and more parks. They're all like right next to each other as well, and they're all really nice, they're all really well kept. The weather stays like this very, very often. All you have to do is just take a look at the Argentinian flag and that will tell you everything you need to know. It's just blue skies and sunshine. And here they've got a track where you can jog, and here they've got a track where you can cycle if you want to. Yeah, it's just very convenient. So we're still in Recoleta. It's about 28 degrees Celsius right now and low humidity, so yeah, it's just really, really nice at the moment, the climate. So this is another park that I've just stumbled into. It's on pretty much the same road that I was on before, but like you can see, like I was telling you before, it's just one park after another, after another, after another. There's just so many around here. So we're just walking up there into an area called Palermo. Again, like I mentioned before, it's like another really nice affluent area, and they've got a zoo there that's free. So we're just gonna take a trip in there and just have a look, see what it's like. So just down there is the zoo, just across the road on the corner over there. So here we are, we finally arrived. It's called Eco Parque. And as you can see, it's free. I just walked in without paying. Feel kind of guilty. So the park or the zoo here, it's not that big, and there aren't too many animals here, but I mean, what do you expect for free? Like, you get what you get. But I still like it, though. It's nice. It's a nice place to just go, like, now and then. So here on the right, we've got the giraffes. Got some ostriches as well. Yeah, I can't remember what these little rodents are called, but apparently they're the second biggest rodents in the world, second behind the capybaras. Look at them. They look like a cross between a rabbit and a deer. Like if a rabbit and a deer were to have a baby, that's what it would look like right there. And these little things just run around the whole park. They're not in any type of enclosure or anything like that. Thank you. And we've got the hippos here in the water. Oh, look at that, they've got an owl over there. Wow. And over there you've got a little monkey island over there. Probably can't see them from here. Oh, there's one.
Para mirar la jirafa me tengo que subir una recta. 8 años, no, antes.
Yeah, the problem is you can't really see a lot of the animals in their enclosures. They've made it kind of difficult to see the actual animals for some reason. Here we've got some llamas or whatever they are. Chilling. We've got a big bison over here. Oh, some flamingos over there.
See, I watch David Allen.
They did a lot of them.
Yeah, so they've been refurbishing this park slash zoo for the past few years, and yeah, I think they've done a really good job. It looks really, really nice here. We'll be able to get a closer look at the flamingos from here. We've got a camel over here. And now I just need to find the straw that broke the camel's back. Imagine living up there in one of those apartments. You'd be able to have like a really nice view of the whole park. Yeah, that was it. That was the little zoo that they've got down here. Like I said, I think it's really nice, especially with all the renovation work that they've been doing to it for the past few years. But anyway, now I'm just going to go across the road and check out this other park. It's called Bosques de Palermo. Yeah, it should be really nice as well. Again, another park over there. I'm telling you, man, this city is just full of parks. They've got some clown activities going on over there. I'm at Bosques de Palermo. It's like another little park here in Buenos Aires. And this track here that you can see, like a lot of people on the evenings and on the weekends, they go like cycling, jogging, skating, all around this park here. It's quite nice. And this is the park itself. And this is a good place to go on a date actually, because you can rent out those little tandem boats and ride all around the little lake that they've got here. This is the little botanical garden that they've got here. And this is where you can come to rent those little tandem boats. There are different versions. You can get ones with roofs, you can get ones like those ones without roofs. This is what Buenos Aires used to look like.
¿Está? ¿No ves qué?
Yeah, so the prices start from 4,500 Argentinian pesos for half an hour and 8,000 pesos for 1 hour. I would say one of the drawbacks, if any, of living in Buenos Aires, or pretty much anywhere in South America though, to be honest, is there is a language barrier. So you would need to learn Spanish. You know, I've been coming here for the past like 4 or 5 years now, and I have been learning, but I've been learning kind of at a slow rate, to be honest. I've been kind of half-assed learning. I've been kind of lackadaisical with it, so, but I am getting there slowly but surely. When I was in high school, for example, I was learning French. So some people learn Spanish in high school, but no, I learned French. So when I came here for the first time, I had to start learning Spanish from the beginning. But like I said, slowly but surely, I am starting to speak more and more the more I come here. But also, like in Brazil, there's a language barrier there too. So every time I go there, you know, I try and learn as much Portuguese as I can. In Southeast Asia though, one of the nice things about being there is there's not much of a language barrier. So I've just spent the last 6 or 7 months in Southeast Asia, mainly places like the Philippines and Malaysia. And there wasn't much of a language barrier there at all, to be honest. Like, most people spoke English, so that was nice. But yeah, it's also nice to learn a new language anyway, so you shouldn't really take it too much of a con, because it's going to benefit you anyway. Like, if you learn Spanish, so many new countries will open up to you, like here in South America, like Chile, Colombia, Venezuela. Like, they all speak Spanish here, and obviously Spain as well in Europe. So yeah, it's good to learn new languages anyway. They've got more like exercise equipment here to do different types of calisthenic exercises. So yeah, they do tend to keep fit here in Buenos Aires at least. Like, I'm sure you would have seen during the course of this video, people roller skating, cycling, jogging, doing these types of calisthenic workouts. Yeah, they do like to keep fit, and it's good because I like to do it too. And like I said, pretty much every park that you can go to, like in the evenings, you'll see that there are people doing different types of exercise classes, and you can join in as well at a small price. So this thing to the left of me over here is called the hippodrome. It's the hipodromo, I think it's called in Spanish. It's basically just like a horse racing stadium that they've got here. Yeah, so no horse racing going on here today, but yeah, again, another really cool place to go to. So right now I'm on my way to this other park. I can't remember what it's called now, but it's not too far away from the Bosques de Palermo park that we just came to just then. But this is another really nice one, so it's got like a pretty big lake in the middle of it as well. So we'll check it out. So yeah, I guess the theme of this video is just checking out the biggest parks in Buenos Aires. But yeah, there's just so many of them, and they're all really good as well. So this is that next park that I was talking about now. This is the entrance to it. And as you can see, it's massive. It's like really, really big. And just on the other side over there, you've got like a tennis club. And they're playing clay over there, kind of like the French Open. I remember when I came here just a few weeks ago and I couldn't even stay just because there were so many mosquitoes and I just got attacked. So yeah, as soon as I came here I had to run away back home. It was just too much. So let's talk about the cost of living here in Buenos Aires. So I would say you can comfortably live here on around $1,500 US per month. That noise behind me, that's the airport. So that's the airport that I actually arrived here at. There's like two main ones. There's the Ezeiza one, which is about 25 miles away from here. And there's that one there, I can't remember the name of it, but it's the closest one to the city. And it's the one that I'll be using to leave here as well in about a month's time when I go back to Brazil. But yeah, in terms of the cost of living, I would say you can live here comfortably on around $1,500 US dollars per month. So yeah, like I'm living in an area called Recoleta, which is where we were before. And it's like a really nice kind of affluent area. It's very safe. Lots of nice parks, as you saw before. And I've got an apartment there. It's like a studio apartment, but it's a fairly decent sized one with a balcony. And I'm paying £630 per month. That's around $700 US. And that's through Airbnb, and it includes everything. So all the bills, like the Wi-Fi, the electricity, the hot water, like everything. But that's through Airbnb, so it's like more expensive. If you were to live here on a longer term basis, and you were to sign like a 6 month or a 12 month contract through a local estate agency, you can get that figure down to around $500 US, $500 to $600 US for an apartment. So yeah, it's good. The other costs are like transportation, very inexpensive as well. You can get pretty much anywhere you need to go to by bus or the subway for less than $1 US. One way, so yeah, it's not expensive at all. They've got subway stations pretty much everywhere, so you can get around very easily. You just need to get one of those little subte cards or sube cards. You load it up with money and you're good to go, kind of like in the UK, the tube. The food costs, I would say in the supermarkets the food is very comparative to the cost in the UK. I thought it'd be cheaper, but I would say it's pretty much the same. In some cases it's actually a little bit more expensive as well. But yeah, I usually spend about £35 to £45 per week on food from the supermarket, but I also eat out as well fairly often as well. At the restaurants, I would say the costs are maybe like 30% to 40% cheaper than in the UK in the restaurants. So yeah, I'd say overall it's not a very expensive place to live in, especially when you compare it to, you know, Western countries like North America or Western Europe. But again, it's only as long as you are earning your salary in a high value currency like US dollars or British pounds or euros or something like that. If you come to live here and you are earning your wages in Argentinian pesos, it's not going to seem like it's cheap to you. It's going to seem like quite expensive. So yeah, it'll be beneficial for you to get some sort of a remote work or start some sort of online business where you can earn money in US dollars or British pounds or something, if you want to come and live here. Overall, I would say the quality of life is really, really good here, especially for digital nomads. Like, if you can earn at least, like I said, $1,500 per month and you learn some Spanish, you can live a good life here. And I always enjoy coming back here, especially like after my stint in Southeast Asia. Usually I spend like 6 months of the year in Southeast Asia and then 6 months of the year in South America. And I split my time usually between like here in Buenos Aires and some places in Brazil. So those are my like favorite places. But like I said, I always enjoy coming back here. It's nice restaurants. It's just a really chill place to be. Like, the people are really nice here. And the weather's great. Yeah, just everything. Like, you can see all the nice parks here. There's activities that you can do throughout the week. Yeah, it's just all good. The food here is great. Yeah, just everything. It's pretty bad here for the locals, I would say, just because of all the inflation. Yeah, it's pretty bad for them. I don't think they would feel that it's a cheap place to live. But for other people, for like I said, digital nomads, people that are coming here and earn in US dollars or whatever, I think they'll find it quite good. Yeah, there was a storm here last week, so it must have caused that tree to just collapse. So this is it, guys. My side quest for today has come to an end. I'm back in Recoleta and I'm at this place called Florales Generica, which is this monument behind me, and as you can see, it's kind of ruined. I'm not sure exactly what happened to it, but I suspect it might be to do with the storms that's been happening recently. And because when I was down here this time last year, it wasn't like this, it was completely fine. But as you can see now, it's completely destructed. And right next to it, just over there, is a university called Facultad de Derecho, which we'll have a look at in a minute, with some interesting architecture there. But yeah, hopefully they'll get this fixed quite soon, because it looked really nice when it was fully functional. But yeah, it's supposed to be a flower, and I think the actual petals there, they open up as the day goes on and then they close up again. But obviously not now, since it's not working. So as you can see behind me is the Facultad de Derecho, Universidad, the university here. Yeah, the architecture is obviously really, really interesting. They don't make them like that anymore. Like these days, universities and just buildings in general are just all glass blocks. Whereas this, you can see it's got like a historical look to it. It's like something from the Roman days. Thank you.
Okay, but